Yes, I have it, Rocky. You're good to go. We start on your first word, sir.
All right, so good evening, everyone. So how many of you all commute or have a car on campus? All right, well, it seems that since most of us drive, how many of you all have experienced issues with finding parking? All right, well, college is no different to that. So according to David Coates, a writer for the Daily Titan from Cal State Fullerton, he stated on March 18th, 2014, that as of 2013, there was a total of 8,640 parking spots for students, and enrollment for that year was, for that fall semester, was 38,325 students. So there seems to be a huge gap between the amount of students there are to the amount of parking spots available for them. So this topic is relevant to you all because you all drive to school or have to find parking for your vehicle on campus. The reason why I'm credible to speak on this topic is because I've did an extensive amount of research on this topic online, as well as I have personally experienced issues with finding parking at different college campuses. Today I would like to persuade you your opinions and thoughts on the issues of college parking and provide a solution to help solve this issue. So I'll first be talking about the cost issues of parking. Next, I'll be addressing how this issue of parking is detrimental to one's grade. And lastly, I would like to provide a solution plan to help solve this issue. So I just discussed a bit about what my speech is going to be about. Next, I'll be addressing my main point, which is the cost issue of parking. So according to Jonathan Diaz, a writer for the Sundial at Cal State University, Northridge, I believe, he stated on March 26, 2013, that the prices of parking at Cal State range from $108 a year at Cal State Monterey Bay to $643 at Cal State San Marcos. So Cal State Fullerton lies on the upper side of that scale, ranging at $472 for the whole semester, or for the whole year, which is a considerably large amount, especially for students who don't have a source of income. In addition to that, students have to spend money on gas trying to find a parking spot. So according to Kimberly Amadeo, an economic analyst for The Balance, she stated on April 11th, 2018, that the average price for gasoline would be $2.41 per gallon for the year of 2018. At the moment, gas price for 1 gallon is at about $3.45 per gallon, which is a huge difference to what was supposed to be, what the price for gasoline was averaged out to be for this year, and that can be detrimental to one's wallet as well as the cost that they're spending on gas. So I've just discussed a bit about the cost issues that come with parking. Next, I'll be addressing the issue of how parking is detrimental to one's grades. So across the nation, we have, according to Jasmine Sanchez, a writer for the Daily Times at Cal State Fullerton, she stated on December 12, 2012, that the unfortunate parking reality puts attendance and eventually grade point averages at risk. Many instructors are known to follow through on their threats to drop students who rack up enough absences. So I personally, last semester, had a professor who would fail students after 3 absences. And with students spending time trying to find parking, you're bound to like at least receive a couple absences from classes, if not being tardy to the class. And that can affect your grade to the point to where you can fail the course and lose money as well for that course. In addition to that, students aren't the only ones that are subjected to this issue of parking, but professors are as well. with professors trying to find parking, they are subjected to being late to their own class and thus reducing the amount of time students are receiving an education. With students receiving less education, they are more likely to not do as well in the class and thus like drop their grade in the class. Mm-hmm. So I've just discussed a bit about the academic and the educational issues that come with parking issues. Lastly, I would like to provide a solution plan to help solve this problem. So, with students all over the nation suffering from this issue of trying to find parking, I've decided to come up with an idea or a solution plan to help solve this problem by creating an app. According to Dora Carol Washi, the CEO of Uber, she stated on April 12, 2018 that checker background checks typically screen potential Uber drivers records within the past 7 years. So I've come up with an idea to create an app that would allow commuters who come to and from school to find other students who live within the same vicinity and be able to, you know, commute with one another. Using the same system as Uber's security safety protocol. In order to ensure the safety of both parties, a background check will be conducted using the similar system as Uber's for everyone who tries to use this app. So in order to ensure the safety, that will be done. By using this app, users will be able to carpool with other college students and overall improve the availability of parking spots available on campus. In addition, both parties will be able to save money on gas as well as, you know, make a new friend. So I've just discussed a bit about my solution plan. I would like to wrap up my speech with a quick summary. So I've just discussed my first main point was the cost issues that came with this issue of parking.
Thank you.